everybody. Welcome to the first episode of the Phantom of the Opera vlogs. I'm Chloe, and I am so excited to be sitting here making this video right now. This year, I had the wonderful opportunity of being cast as Christine Daaé in the Phantom of the Opera, and I filmed from December of 2020 all the way when I still hadn't even gotten the role. I hadn't gotten cast yet. I was filming the audition process and was like, maybe I'll get cast, fingers crossed, all the way until May of 2021, which was closing day as Christine in Phantom of the Opera. I've done vlogs of my musical theater productions that I've been in the past, but I really wanted to come at this one from a different angle because this production and this process was so unique and so special to me that I really thought it would be worth doing it like this. So you will see me, who is the current version of myself, pop in every once in a while to just kind of chat and make sure that all of the timelines and memories that are kept in these vlogs make sense. I want it to flow really, really well because I think this is such a special time capsule to have for myself and for the cast, probably, I hope. A quick little disclaimer, I want to acknowledge that the audio will improve throughout the next few videos because I didn't know at the time, but my microphone on the camera I was previously using for these first three vlogs was breaking. It's not very noticeable, but I do want to acknowledge that if the audio is for whatever reason really bothering you, it shouldn't, but if it does, come back in the next few vlogs and it'll be all fixed up for you. Anyways, I am so excited to be sharing this journey with you. There are new episodes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday for the next 3 weeks, and I could not be more excited to share it all with you. I don't want to keep you any longer, so grab some snacks and get ready for the ride because the vlogs get better every episode. Starts with me getting ready for my audition and then the auditions themselves, which were self-tapes at the time, which means you just film yourself in the room doing the audition because we were still very much in a pandemic with absolutely no end in sight at the time. So we had to film and send those auditions in before, which I kind of thought was better because now you actually get to see the audition. Here we go. I'm currently getting ready for my audition.
I still have to kind of memorize my monologue a little more. I'm singing Green Finch and Linnet Bird from Sweeney Todd. And then I worked all day yesterday on my dance, so I'm hoping that as well.
The fun part is trying to make my little setup look professional. As if. That was me prepping for my audition. Here is a snippet of my vocal audition and of my dance audition. I also did have a 1 minute monologue as an acting portion of the audition, but I decided to keep that private just because it's a little bit cringy looking back on it. So here is my vocal audition. Like I said earlier, it's really interesting to look at my vocal technique and how it improves in every single episode and every time I sing on the vlogs, really. You see an improvement in my voice and it's really, really fascinating to watch. But it's also really cool to see how my dancing technique changed too. Because watching that video, I'm like, wow, I'm really stiff. But now I had to do that dance as Christine with a bunch of ballerinas on point. And my dancing technique also really, really improved. My acting did too, but I'm not gonna show you the monologue. Just trust me on it, okay? So moving forward, after auditions, the what was to be cast was just kind of sitting in limbo for a little while, waiting for callbacks to be announced. but they never got announced. And I started feeling this sort of, if you're an actor or a performer of any kind who waits for cast lists to come out, I started feeling the famous like, ouch, better luck next time feeling. And sure enough, this is where it starts to get good. I opened my phone and lo and behold,
I got the cast list back yesterday.
I literally got Christine. I don't even like, I'm so, like, I could cry talking about it. I'm so grateful to just be able to, like, do something. And then for it to be this amazing. It's December 19th right now, and rehearsals start on January 12th. Ah! Okay, I'm just gonna practice now.
You guys! I can take this off. I'm alone in the car. But I'm so excited right now. I'm sorry about that. I just realized how loudly I screamed. But I have a cast party right now. I have a cast party. So I'll try and get a few pictures or videos there. I always feel bad intruding with my vlogs, but then everyone loves it when I do. So I'm like, what do I do? When I'm normally, I always run over my dad's lawn. Anyway, I gotta go. Do the show, the whole thing.
I don't know how to sing this.
I'm back from the cast party. It was really, really fun. It was my first time meeting the guy playing Raul. I still can't figure out if it's Raul or Rao, like one syllable or two, whatever. But so his name's Tyler. He was really, really cool. And then I already knew Reese, who's playing Phantom. It's really, really cool. I'm excited to see how we do this. I also really want to do something like that with that group again. So rehearsal, I don't think we'll do anything before rehearsals start. Maybe we will. I would think it would be fun if we did. But rehearsals start on January 12th. Today is like December 29th, 28th. I'm not sure. But yeah, so yay.
12 minutes late. I left my water in my car. I just realized that like just right now in a second. But I'm here now. I have my script. I have everything I need.
Except
what happened right before this?
We drama.
Your childhood friends though.
Yeah.
Like you guys have known each other for a long time, but then you haven't seen each other for a while.
Was there a past relationship between Christine and Raul?
I think we liked each other.
Yeah, I think they had like little crushes on each other.
But they were like 14.
Oh, okay.
They were really little. Until I log in.
We're warming up. You guys have missed this.
Then on different shade, you're gonna swoop to the left and swoop to the right.
Okay, I just finished a dance rehearsal. I just kind of sat here for a second. I can tell I'm having a headache. It's been a while since I've done so much in one day. Like so much rehearsal stuff. I've been working all day every day, but I don't know, that's just not the same as rehearsal. So I'm doing a little outfit change. Just putting on a bigger jacket. And then I'm going to my voice lesson. So yay, here I go.
Past the point of no return, no going back, no. Sleeping.
just got home from my vocal lesson. We went.
Throughout the show, I was working with one of my closest humans from the theater world. So before we continue, I would like to give a huge shout out to Miss Kyla Davidson for always being my mentor and helping me out through the entire process.
It is. I got there at 7:30. It is now 10:30. We went for 3 hours. Isn't that crazy?
As you can see, after over a year without doing any theater, I was very hungry to get back into it, and I started working right away, nonstop, to tell this story. This is something that I don't think I actually talk about at all in the vlogs, maybe one time in passing conversation later on in the series, but I don't think I ever talk about this. I've been doing musical theater since I was 6, and I started really taking it seriously and doing, I think, 2 to 4 shows a year, but I would never do less than 2 shows a year. Since I think I was 8 years old, usually it was about 3 shows a year, since I was 7 or 8. And I'd never gone without taking more than a month's break, and I only took month-long breaks just because that's what you did. You would take month-long breaks in between the shows. And I decided for the first time in my life, my junior year, that I wanted to take a 3-month break from musical theater, and I wanted to get back into it in summer. Well, I decide this, and then we go into spring break, and then the pandemic happened. So I believe the last time at that time that I had performed was November of 2019. So here we were, literally just over a year without having done anything in theater. And I got Christine in Phantom of the Opera. And if you are a musical theater person, you know that one of the biggest roles in Broadway, if not one, like the biggest female role other than like Elle in Legally Blonde, in Phantom of the Opera, it's like as big as you get. And that's where I was starting back off after my year-long break. So I could not have been more excited to get right back into the swing of things. I really hope you guys are enjoying the vlog so far. I'm so excited to continue sharing this story with all of you guys. The vlogs get better every episode, so stay tuned for the next. Bye!